Okay, we're going to talk about the ratio and root tests here. If you're looking for information about alternating series and absolute convergence, you need to look at the previous learning module. So the idea of both the ratio and the root tests is we're going to compare things to a geometric series. And remember that a geometric series is something of the form sum of some constant times a common ratio to the nth power. Now, if that common ratio is less than 1, the terms get smaller and the geometric series converges. If the ratio, common ratio is bigger than 1, the terms get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and it diverges. And it also diverges if rho is equal to 1 or minus 1. But actually, for our purposes, that's going to be a borderline case. It does diverge, but if you bump it a little bit, you could make it converge by making it the ratio just a tiny bit smaller. So the idea is we're going to compare something to a geometric series. And if it's eventually less than a geometric series with a ratio less than 1, then it's going to converge absolutely. And if it's eventually bigger than a geometric series with a ratio bigger than 1, then it diverges. And the reason we don't deal with things with a geometric series of size equal to 1 is that there's always a little bit of error. If you get something where the ratio looks like 1, well, then it might be a little bit below, it might be a little bit above, the test isn't going to work. So here is the test. Define R to be the limit of the ratio of successive terms. So you take the n plus first term, divide by the nth term, take the absolute value, and take the limit of that. If the limit of that ratio is less than 1, then the series converges absolutely. If the limit of that ratio is bigger than 1, then the series diverges. If the limit of the ratio is equal to 1, you can't tell. There are examples where the ratio is 1 that it converges. There are examples where the ratio is 1 and it diverges. You just can't tell. Finally, a couple things about the limit not existing. The limit doesn't exist because things get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. That is, if the limit is infinity, that counts as bigger than 1. But if the limit doesn't exist because it keeps oscillating, in that case, we throw up our hands and say, we don't know what to do. The test doesn't work. So here are some examples. First example is we look at the sum of n to the fifth over 2 to the n. And if you write out the first few terms, you know, 2 to the fifth is big. 2 to the fifth over 2 squared is 8. 3 to the fifth over 3 2 cubed is even bigger, it looks pretty bad. But after a while, the terms start to get smaller. And if you look at the ratio, you take n plus 1 to the fifth over 2 to the n plus 1, divided by n to the fifth divided by 2 to the n. Almost all the factors here are going to cancel. There's just going to be one factor of 2 left over in the denominator. See, 2 to the n divided by 2 to the n plus 1 is a half. Then n plus 1 to the fifth divided by n to the fifth, that's n plus 1 over n to the fifth. And n plus 1 over n gets closer and closer to 1. So n plus 1 over n to the fifth gets closer and closer and closer to 1. Divided by 2 gets closer and closer and closer to a half. So in this case, the ratio gives us r is a half, and it converges. Our next example is 50 to the n over n factorial. If we do this, we say the n plus first term is 50 to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial, divided by 50, the nth term is 50 to the n over n factorial. We rearrange our terms and we say, well, 50 to the n plus 1 divided by 50 to the n, well, that's 50. N factorial divided by n plus 1 factorial, that's 1 over n plus 1. Now, at first, this ratio is very, very big. But as n gets bigger and bigger and bigger, this ratio gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So the limit of the ratio is 0. 0 is less than 1, so the whole thing converges. Last example. How about the sum of n cubed? Now, this obviously diverges. The terms get bigger and bigger and bigger. But you can't tell from the ratio test. If you do the ratio test, you get a limit of 1. Because n plus 1 cubed over n cubed is n plus 1 over n cubed, and that goes to 1. So even though this is obviously divergent, the test can't figure it out. If you did the sum of n to the minus third, that converges, but again, the test can't tell. If the test gives you a ratio of 1, it doesn't work. The test just doesn't tell you which way it goes at all. So, why does the ratio test work? Let's suppose that our limiting ratio is 0.98. Now, that's really just a placeholder for any old number that's less than 1. But let's suppose it's 0.98. If the ratio is 0.98, that means the limit of an plus 1 over an is 0.98. And what's a limit? It's what you get really, really, really close to eventually. So eventually, an plus 1 is very, 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 very close to 0.98. How close? As close as you want. And particularly, it's eventually less than 0.99. And if it's eventually less than 0.99, then after a while, each term is just 0.99 times the previous term or less. So eventually our terms are less than some constant times 0.99 to the nth power. Each new power just gives us a factor of 0.99. But that's a geometric series. You know, our series converges absolutely by comparison to the sum of c times 0.99 to the n. This converges absolutely because it's a geometric series. This converges absolutely because it's smaller than this, or rather, it's eventually smaller than that. Well, what if you had a ratio bigger than 1? What if it was, say, 1.02? Well, then the limit would be 1.02. So the ratio would be eventually close to 1.02. So in particular, the limit would eventually be bigger than 1.01. And that means that an will eventually be bigger than a constant times 1.01 to the nth power. You know, if the ratio is 1.01 or bigger, it means each term is bigger than the previous term. The terms are growing on us. If the terms are growing, then their sum can't possibly converge. So the sum diverges. Now, I use the numbers 0.98 and 0.99 and 1.02 and 1.01. But really, if instead of 1.02 you had some other number bigger than 1, then all you needed to do was use, instead of 1.01, you use a number somewhere between 1 and r. On the other side, if you had r instead of 0.98, you pick a number between r and 1 instead of 0.99. The same proof works no matter what the value of r is. If it's bigger than 1, it diverges. If it's less than 1, it converges absolutely. If it's equal to 1, as we've seen with n cubed and n to the minus 3, you just can't tell.